Hey guys, welcome to our small piece of the internet where we take a moment to ramble about some movies. And now our main rambler, the Rambling Mango. Malango, how you doing this week, sir?
I'm good. How you doing, Mike?
Excellent, excellent. So we don't have a whole lot of time here this week, but I still want to get your take on your movies. And I do have one I want to talk about briefly, ever so briefly. So tell me, what's going on in the movies this week, sir?
Yeah, this is going to be a short show, but there wasn't a lot going on in news anyway. So I'll just run down the lineup really quick, and then we can talk about the movie you want to talk about. In the weekend lineup, we had Ride Along that came out this weekend. That was the big one. We also had Lone Survivor. Oh, these notes are so wrong. We had Lone Survivor come out. That did not come out this weekend, but that held strong at second with 23 million. Ride Along actually pulled in about 40 something million with a 15% only 15% on Rotten Tomatoes. But I mean, that was because that was a comedy involving the infamous Ice Cube and Kevin Hart. So I mean, like, that's one that I'm still interested to see, but you know, the ratings don't pretty much, I think that's based on your own humor. If you like Kevin Hart, then you'll probably enjoy this movie and the humor that he presents.
I can almost guarantee it's better than Kevin Hart on my iPhone during Waze.
Yes, probably, definitely. We also had the Nut Job, the children's film, pulled in about $20.6 million. That is still 13%, so some parents out there would drive to take their kids. And the big one, Jack Ryan, Shadow Recruit. I actually wanted to see this. I had free passes, so I missed that. A whopping 63% on Rotten Tomato, but it did not pull any numbers, big numbers, in the box office. Mm-hmm. So that was kind of another performer. Moving on to movie news, since we're speeding this along, like I said, there's not a lot of news going on. So there were some things that I thought were pretty interesting. There is a Fantastic Four screenplay coming out. So we might be getting a reboot to Fantastic Four.
They've been talking about this for a little bit.
Yeah. It'd be interesting to see, Marvel, now that they've had a couple goes at it, you know.
Well, remember, yeah. This is still Fox, isn't it? Did they get...
Is this Fox?
I think it's still Fox.
Yes, it is Fox.
Fox is really interested in making these bigger world things with X-Men and Fantastic Four. Even, like, kind of floating the rumor of an X-Men versus Fantastic Four could be several years down the road as well. I don't think
it
will happen at all.
Well, I mean, the guy that did Chronicles is also reported as somebody who he might be playing a role in this. So, yeah, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how that goes. That's something of interest. Jesse Lee Martin, he's a really awesome actor, most notably Law & Order. That's probably not what he's most notably known. But he's going to be a role in Flash. On the nice. WB. So as a Detective West from CDW's or CW's Flash. So that'll be interesting to see that they're expanding those kind of universes.
And that's I know they're introducing the Flash currently on Arrow. This is going to be a direct spinoff of that, correct?
Yeah, apparently. Which brought up a question of, speaking of Arrow, I am very behind on it. Is it worth continuing?
Yes. I think if you know a little bit of DC, they're dropping a lot of hints in there. They're adding a lot of stuff. Like, there's some Batman stuff in there if you know a couple names. Actually, if you watch recent movies, you'll be like, oh, really? That guy? I think it's fleshing out very well. I'm enjoying it. I think you should get into it.
Yeah. All right. Another quick note back on Kevin Hart. It seems that, you know, with all the success in movies, he's about due for another voiceover. So we have Captain Underpants, and there's a whole bunch of big names for people playing voice talents for that. So that'll be interesting to see. you got Nick Roll, you got Jordan Peele from Key & Peele.
Wow.
You got Thomas Middleditch, I think is his name, and Ed Helms. So, I mean, that's going to be an interesting lineup. That's some very funny actors and comedians on there. So it'll be interesting to see how that rolls out. And then the last bit of news I thought was just interesting. Breaking Bad's Aaron Paul is up for a role in Dark Tower.
Nice. And of course, Dark Tower is the kind of massive world Stephen King kind of thing, which I mean, they're even saying like parts of, I'm not familiar a lot with Stephen King stuff, but yeah, like parts of The Stand and other stuff tie into this whole Dark Tower universe in some ways.
Yeah, I'm not too familiar with the whole universe of Dark Tower, but I do think it's interesting that to see him play a role. I don't know. It'd be interesting to see his character.
Mm-hmm. I know it from listening to the shows where they are huge fans of Dark Tower, and have been talking about like the prospects of this. And I know they've been talking about maybe part of it will be an HBO series, and then there'll be movies and stuff. This looks like this article goes a little bit more into whatever the latest plan is for it.
Interesting. Yeah, like I said, I'm pretty curious to see like off the off of the hills or off, you know, with the finalization of Breaking Bad, his character was so like defined in that. It's always interesting to see how actors bounce in a role that, and I guess in this one will be very much darker. So
awesome.
But yeah, and then before we get to our quick water cooler, we'll just say that the big movie coming out in the theaters this weekend, I believe, is I, Frankenstein. I have no interest in seeing that, but I like the actor.
They followed me on Twitter.
Yes. So.
And wouldn't respond to me.
Yeah, but that's going to be a very over-budgeted visual effects that I don't think they're going to recoup their money.
Over-budgeted.
But we'll see. So let's go to the reviews and water cooler. Kind of reversal here, but we'll end on this note. So yeah, a movie that I watched this weekend or this past week based on Chachi's recommendation was The Last Stand. And
his or mine? Because I talked about this last week, I thought.
Was it yours? I thought it was Chachi's.
Yeah, I watched it. I liked this movie.
Yeah, I was pleasantly surprised by it. I thought, you know, you had your rich kingpin drug lord who was, you know,
who loves fast cars.
Cars, yeah. Forrest Whitaker's character disappoints me sometimes. You know, there's that role of people that continue to play the same kind of role where he plays a detective and mm-hmm. or an FBI agent or, you know, something like that. I just felt like that would be something that I'd like to see walk, like when he got that script. Maybe he thought this was going to be something, or maybe it was a favor that he was doing for somebody.
I think it's a payday.
Yeah? You're like, oh, let's pay you a lot of extra
money. I think you
money.
Got a lot of people in this movie that this was a payday.
Yeah, I mean, Arnold, though, because you got to think, like, somebody came in like, this is one of those movies that we're going
to
help.
Yeah, but I don't think you gotta do a lot to talk Arnold into it. And it really is kind of seems like Arnold's return kind of thing, isn't it? I mean, because the whole thing is he's old, he's a cop,
yeah,
he's still a badass, and that's what we're trying to say about Arnold Schwarzenegger. He's old, he's still a badass, right?
I'll be back. So,
no, I thought I enjoyed it. It's everything I love about an old Arnie movie.
Yeah, I thought it was very enjoyable. I would recommend it. I would actually go as far as saying Redbox it. I would take the effort to go find a Redbox and rent it if you haven't seen it. It's pretty good.
And it is right now on Netflix.
Oh, it is on Netflix?
Yeah, that's where I caught it.
Even better.
Yes.
So yeah, stream that.
Yeah.
Do it. Hey, you saw Hansel and Gretel. That's
I saw Hansel
I have
and Gretel. This is Witch Hunters. Hansel and Gretel, Witch Hunters. With, what is his name? Jeremy Renner, who is a Hawkeye in Avengers. He's been in Bourne Legacy and all kinds of Mission Impossible, the last one. And this was, I had no expectations going into this. Because I'm like, okay, it looks interesting. It came out about a year ago, I believe. I enjoyed it. I really enjoyed this movie, like way more than I expected. It wasn't like the best movie ever, but for a Netflix stream, it was a pleasant surprise. So basically, it's Hansel and Gretel, and they actually do start with like the story, you know, the candy house and all that kind of stuff. But then it's like, what happens after they kill their first witch? They keep killing witches.
Ooh, didn't see that coming.
No, of course not. I did read, this is supposed to be the first of an ongoing series, hopefully. They set up, I think, really well for that. I look forward to see where they go with that. I could see this being another kind of underworld, kind of alternative, creepy horror comedy series. Will Ferrell produced this.
Interesting.
The Anchorman produced this. But it was pretty good. I had a lot of fun with it. But I like these little, like, you know, fantasy, you know, crazy, still kind of badass kind of films like this. So I recommend it. It's another one streaming on Netflix right now, but you have a chance, either Redbox it or whatever. I think it's worthwhile.
Yeah, definitely. Then I'll probably check it out. You said it's on Netflix?
It's on Netflix.
Is that all right? So let's add something new to the segment, since we have to wrap up pretty quickly. Are there any movies that you recommend for next week? Since you're not a box office person,
for next week, as in like
check for movies that you recommend. I'm guessing you could recommend that one, Hansel and Gretel.
I will recommend this one.
Hansel and Gretel.
Yeah, and that's the thing. And you know, I mostly watch stuff on my Netflix, on my Amazon Prime, Hulu. There's a couple actually on Hulu I want to see. They're WWE films, so I wasn't going to pay for them because they're usually eh. So I'm hoping to get one of those in here over the weekend, and I might be able to tell you about that. Remember, I was checking out the ones before Dead Man Down, for instance, which was a WWE film. So I'm always interested to just see what they're doing with it. Like, what did they do with John Cena in this film and stuff like that. But so that's the other recommendation. If you are a wrestling fan and kind of want to see what these films they've been doing are about, Hulu. I believe the movies are just Hulu Plus, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know. I haven't logged in like the free Hulu to see what the deal is. But they do have The Reunion, Inside Out, which is with Triple H. They also have The Chaperone, which was a fine, a lot of these times these movies just seem like I expect to see this on USA on a Sunday afternoon kind of feel to them.
Really.
The Chaperone was very, very much it. It has the younger daughter from Modern Family. Something else to potentially to check out there for anybody that's into those kinds of films. So,
interesting.
That's all I got. Yeah.
All right. Well, I have three, but they're Jack Reacher is on Netflix. I checked that out.
Saw it when it came
Pittsburgh,
out.
It's a Pittsburgh one. I enjoyed it. I thought it could be a lot more violent, but it's still, I think, decently good.
Makes me feel weird to walk in front of the baseball stadium on the north side.
Yeah. Well,
that was a little disturbing.
Dodge and weave.
Yes. Good film.
Drinking Buddies is another one that I highly recommend. Drinking it is a little buddies. Rough. The guy, the main guy from Girls, or not Girls, New Girl. I can't remember these names. Anyway, check it out. Drinking Buddies. Awesome movie.
Oh, Olivia.
I think that's it.
Awesome. So, all right, check it out. I'm at Sorgatron on the Twitters. He's at Rambling Mango. And that's all the movies for this week. We'll see you next time.
Oh, Olivia Wilde, Jack Johnson,
yes!
And Kendrick. two very hot, attractive women and two very funny guys. Check it out. I'm sorry. Rambling Mango.
He keeps rambling. We'll see you next time.